So, what's the difference between tapered threads and straight threads? First off, let me specify which threads I'll be talking about. In the US, the standard for pipe threads is called NPT, which is short for National Pipe Thread, and includes many different types of threads, such as NPT, NPS, NPTR, and many others. But in this video, I'll only be covering the two most popular threads in the plumbing industry, and those are NPT and NPS. NPT stands for National Pipe Taper, and NPS stands for National Pipe Straight, and they both have their own uses in the plumbing world. If we look at both types of threads side by side, the first thing we could notice is that the tapered threads are in fact tapered, or slightly conical, meaning that if we would continue these lines, they would eventually meet up down the line as opposed to straight threads, which are parallel to each other, and would never meet. The female threads of both respective types are also different. The tapered threads have tapered female threads, and the straight threads have straight female threads. But how does all of this relate to how they actually seal? To better understand, let's take a close-up look of the actual threads and what each part is called. This here is the root, this is the crest, and this right here is the flank. If we zoom in on the tapered threads, we could see that they use the actual threads themselves to create a seal thanks to the flanks on both the pipe and fitting compressing against each other when they're torqued. Now, that was a mouthful. This compression creates a lot of resistance as it's being tightened, and to aid the threads to go in all the way and fully seat, PTFE tape or Teflon tape is used around the threads. Teflon is known for its non-stick and frictionless surface, so it helps a lot at getting this task done. This tape is also used to seal to some extent, but it's not its primary purpose as many tend to believe. A better option for sealing would be to use hemp and paste. Hemp, which is used more in the UK and neighboring countries, actually expands when it comes in contact with liquid or moisture, so it's better at sealing, but not as good for fighting friction, and it takes a lot longer to install. If you want to know more about PTFE tape, just watch this complete guide right here. And that is how tapered threads work. But what about straight threads? Straight threads, unlike the previous, do not depend on the actual threads themselves to create a leak-free joint. Instead, they use an O-ring or rubber seal, a compression ferrule, or a flared connection. The threads are basically what attaches both pieces together, and the connection is what seals it and makes it liquid or airtight. If we look at the O-ring or rubber seal, the liquid that's being transported in the pipe would go into the threads, but not go past the seal. These threads do not require any sealant such as Teflon tape or pipe dope, like tapered threads do, which is a common mistake that a lot of beginners make. Now that we know how both of these work, where and for what are they used for? In homes, tapered threads are mostly used for shower stubouts, natural gas lines for barbecues or fireplaces, on accessories such as PRVs, hot water tank inlets and outlets, and many more. These connections are also often preferred for behind wall applications as servicing is not an option. As for straight threads, you'll find these on compression fittings such as stop valves and supply lines for sinks and toilets, on hoses such as garden hoses and washing machine hoses. You'll find them on older oil burners as flared connections for oil lines, on HVAC or air conditioning lines, and a lot of hydraulic systems for non-plumbing applications. So, what are the pros and cons for both? Tapered threads don't react well to frequent assembly and disassembly, as each time the threads deform ever so slightly, which would eventually cause leaks. The fact that they need to be tightened a lot for them not to leak makes them more prone to cracking. The lubricant used on the thread, such as PTFE tape or pipe dope, could easily contaminate a system, which is why tape isn't commonly used on gas systems. And finally, they aren't the best for high-pressure systems, such as hydraulic systems. What is good about them is that they're readily available in stores. They come in a large variety of shapes and sizes, and they're easy to assemble as there's no parts like on flared or compression connections, for example. As for straight or parallel threads, they are a tad more expensive. They are harder to access as you won't always be able to find flared or specialized O-ring fittings at your big box stores, and they don't give body or rigidity to a system like tapered threads do. What is nice about them is that they don't seize up like NPT threads do, as they have a looser fit, they don't require as much force to get a leak-free connection, and they don't require any sealants, making for a cleaner connection and less chances of contamination. And that covers it for this video. I hope you learned something, and if you did, don't forget to hit the like button, share it, and subscribe for more educational videos like this one. And until the next one, thanks for watching.